these guys right here. They are some really beautiful green agates, and green is hands down my favorite color. So I think this is gonna be really fun. And we're gonna be cutting them open on my 6-inch high-tech diamond saw and using a different blade today. Hi. This is the thin notched blade. It is mighty thin. So we will get that all set up. So this is our very first agate that we are going to cut, and it's kind of a tricky one because it's got a bunch of these windows that are kind of like right next to each other. So when thinking about where to cut this, I like this face a lot, so I want to see what shoots through that way. So I'm going to cut it right through here. Now I am cutting through a window right here, which is not really what you're supposed to do. I think it's going to be okay. So let's see if our theory is right with that. And we get a nice banded face with what looks like this purple chalcedony right here shooting through. So we had a little bit of breakage right up here, and these are kind of funky agates. They're not like your typical agates, which is fine. I'm excited to see what's going on the inside of this guy. So let's peek at it. Oh! Oh my goodness, look at the beautiful details in that. That's crazy. Those oranges and yellows, that is going to be so fun getting this face right here polished up. And I know it's a super, oh, you can't even see it, but I know it's super super thin, but that thin notched blade cut through this like butter. Yeah, that is a really really fun and beautiful first cut. Look at the depth right in here. That's gonna be so fun to see all polished up. Gosh, that makes me happy. That's so sweet, so green, so pretty. So I am not sure which one to cut next. I kind of want to cut one of these guys. Well, let's do this one. While the blade is brand new, this is a big guy, and we got this window right here, micro little window right here. So let's cut it right down the middle like that, and hopefully on the inside we expose whatever is running in through there, and hopefully some more bands just like the other one. Oh, oh my gosh. That is so crazy. Wow. That's insane. The colors in that are just phenomenal. Oh my goodness. It's so dark. It's so green. Let me see if I can get a little bit more light on that. All right, so I just switched over to a different camera because this one picks up a lot more light. And look at how insane that is. Reminds me of malachite. Beautiful, beautiful yellows, little micro geode pocket. I 100%, after looking at this, did not think, well, I saw this while I was cutting, I was like, okay, this might be kind of sweet. But initially, I didn't think it was gonna be that cool. That is so beautiful. Oh, I'm loving these Bulgarian agates, they are so fun. This is the next guy that's up. It's a little bit more
lighter,
a lot of like, fractures in it and stuff, so I am not too sure. I was gonna cut this one right down the middle here because of that window right there, and hopefully it runs deep. It's the only spot that there's really a window. I think that'd be a good spot, so let's cut it and see if it plays out. Let's see if this one played out. Oh, that is so pretty. Not as hacked as the other two, but still really, really beautiful. It's got just that window right there that was like starting to peek through a little bit. Maybe in the polishing process, I'll lean into that a little bit harder. This is probably just a little bit of a lighter one. Still pretty, still like that one. And the next two, this guy and this guy, I think these two are gonna be really, really special. But before I cut those two, I need to ask you a huge favor. If you are enjoying this video so far, help support it by hitting that thumbs up button and make sure you leave a comment letting me know what you think about this video and if you want to see more fun and different agate cutting videos, like cutting these Bulgarian agates, because I've never seen anybody cut them before. I know it's been done before, but I've never seen videos of it, and I like purchasing stuff like that and being able to share it with all of you. So if you like that, let me know what you think. And if you have any special agate requests you'd like to see cut, leave a comment and let me know. But let's pick out our next agate to cut. So this guy is going to be the next one we cut, and I just realized I didn't have my external mic plugged in the last couple of shots with this camera, so sorry about that. 4.5 years into this and I'm still making mistakes like that. But for this guy, you can see we got some really, really beautiful bands right here. This window, it runs through all the way. There's beautiful windows all over this piece. Beautiful bands right here. I want that pattern on the inside like that. So I'm gonna cut it right through the middle, right there. Right, all right. Let's see if I was right with my theory. All right. Oh, yes, and it is good. Oh my gosh. Funky little blowout there. It's like a little weird, really weird little geode pocket. Those bands are so awesome. Really, really excited to get these polished, especially with that depth and everything like that. I think these are gonna turn out really, really great. That is really, really pretty. Green and yellow, such great contrasting colors. So good. I did that on the first try. This is our very last Bulgarian agate. And I sat here and did this for a long time when I first saw it. And I was like, where do I cut it? It's got so many windows. Window, 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 window. All these windows. Where do you cut it so that you're not cutting through a window? And I think trying to cut it right in through here is a good idea, but then there's a window, right? And then I was like, well, what about right through here? And there's a window. It's so hard. We're gonna have to sacrifice one window. So I'm thinking, cut through this way right here. Hopefully that pattern, those bands run through like that. So let's see how it looks after we cut it. So I think at the end it kind of fractured on me a little bit and I wasn't able to get it totally clean cut, but you can see there, I can't really like slide it, but we'll work that out in the grinding process before the polishing process. But I believe I got this exactly where I wanted it. I think it was a great placement. I hope it plays out with beautiful bands inside, but let's check it out. See. Oh my gosh. Oh, it's a geode agate. You. Oh, it's so pretty. I can't wait to see it without all these scratches in there. That's one thing I will say I've noticed with this thin notched. It leaves a lot more saw blade marks, but man, it cuts through it quick. That is so crazy. Little chipping right here we'll have to work out, a little bit of a rounded face polish. And even right in here, a little bit of work for us to do. But good golly, looks like a natural fracture running right in there as well. That is so pretty. Purple, and I wouldn't say it's amethyst, this is like purple chalcedony in there. Little geode pocket, yellow bands, yellow and green bands. Man, how cool are these Bulgarian agates? They're all so great. So what I'm gonna do now is do a little bit of tidying up while Taylor number one cleans up the saw and gets all the water taken out of it and all that good stuff. Taylor number two is gonna clean all of those saw blade marks off of those cut agates. He's gonna use the end diamond. So So I got all of those run through that diamond lap, and after I dried them off and inspected them, I realized I'm gonna have to do a lot more work than just grinding them on the diamond lap. So I was hopeful that it could just be that easy, but as is with lapidary, it's never just that easy. So I'm gonna have to do a lot of rounded face polishes on a majority, well, all of these, because there's so many fractures, so many little chips and everything that I need to grind out to try to give them the best opportunity for a perfect face polish. So I have put them in order from most potential to least potential, because one of my favorite ones actually is got the least potential. There's so many fractures in it, and they're just, it's kind of a chippy agate. Bulgarian agates are kind of beat up. they're super beautiful, but it's just how it goes. So I'm just gonna take it one face polish at a time. So that's kind of the process. Let me finish this and then I will show you the lineup and what I'll be polishing on. So here is our lineup. These are the ones I'm going to be polishing first. These are last. These ones sadly have these fractures all over inside it. What a bummer. I really like this one. It's got so many fractures. Hopefully it turns out okay in the polishing process, but we'll just have to wait and see. So I'm going to be giving a lot of these rounded face polishes. I'm going to be doing that by grinding on my 220 grit wheel and polishing it all the way through to the 8,000 grit here. So we're going to be polishing on my Cab King with those res wheels. My Cab King and the res wheels and the discount codes, they're all going to be linked in the description box below. Same goes for the 6-inch saw that I used to cut all these with the blade and everything like that. So I'm gonna get to polishing, and after each individual face polish is completed, I will show you, we'll look at it in great detail. I have a feeling this is gonna be a lot harder than, well, I guess I'm anticipating it to be hard, so I think it's gonna be kind of a hard process, but I'll let you know as it goes if it was easy or not. But I'll get to work in here on the Cab King and we'll see you in a second. So we got our first face polish done. It didn't take too long, wasn't too bad. And I, with this huge pocket here, it actually turned out really, really well. It's got so much beautiful depth in there. Those bands are awesome. That green is awesome. Oh, it actually turned out really, really well. I'm happy we at least got one polished one from this batch. I'm going to work on the other half of this and then, you know, just keep trucking through them. So as we polish them, like I said, we'll keep showing you. So we got our second half of that one done and it looks just as good as the first. I love all the depth in there with that beautiful moss in that center, that sweet little pocket there, and all those beautiful yellow bands. So again, that one didn't take too long. Really happy with how that turned out. So we'll move on to our next piece. And our third face polish is done. Look at the beautiful depth inside that and the light play on there. That is so awesome. I love the bands around the outside of the yellow. It is so pretty. Gosh, it just looks like you're looking into a cave. It's so cool how it gets dark in there. Oh, I love it. So great. And I just finished our fourth face. That is so pretty. Look at the light play on there. Woo! Those yellows and greens, so awesome. I love how in the center of right there, it just looks like it just falls into the depths. So dark, it's like honey. It is sweet, I love it. Love it so much. But here's the deal, I am so tired. I'm starting to get like bug-eyed. I can't even say it, bug-eyed. I'm tired, so I'm gonna pause for safety and I'll hit back. I don't even know what I'm saying. I'm so tired. We'll get back to it tomorrow. See you then.
So it is day 3 of the project. Day 2 was yesterday, and I got all of the other Bulgarian agates all polished up, but I was so tired at the end of that polishing session. I was like, we'll just wrap this thing up tomorrow, which is now. So we have all of them done, and they are looking so beautiful. They're so green and so yellow, and there's so much beautiful depth. So let's take a peek at everything else that I polished, and I think you're gonna love it. These are so beautiful.
So here's our batch, and I think we left off with showing you these ones right here, but this is probably the least of the three. It took a great polish, but as you can see, it has these natural fractures in it. Now, there's nothing you can do about it. You could put some sort of super glue or epoxy or something. A lot of people suggest stuff like that. I don't do anything like that with any of my polished agates. They are, as is, as good as they're gonna get with what my hands can do to them. I'm not gonna add anything unnatural to them. So I think these ones are still very, very pretty in their own right. It's just something about these Bulgarian ones, they just have a lot of naturalness to them, and part of the naturalness is fractures. Like you can see as the light rolls here, it's got a couple big fractures in the faces. Just kind of is what it is. They're still very pretty. Still really cool. Really happy I put all the work in on those. And, almost dropped that one. But I really love in the center there, it's like so much depth. So purple, so yellow. I think that one is super, super pretty. If it just didn't have those fractures, but that's part of its story, you know? These ones turned out really, really well. Light playing on there. Like you can see right there in the light, it's got some natural chipping. It's just, and that was like the third time I've worked something out in this area. It just keeps coming. These Bulgarian agates are just kind of, they're little tricksters. But look in here with that depth. That is so, so cool. It reminds me of malachite. That green banded areas. Pretty cool. Really, really like these last two pieces. I think they turned out really well. Got little geode pockets in there as well. So yeah, that is our batch of green Bulgarian agates.